everybody. My name is Nikki Sav, and I'm not exactly new to the Giants content creating community. I actually do run a Fireside Giants TikTok account, and I've been on Tana's channel a million times and have been on Hug's channel, but I guess you could say I'm new to the YouTube community. I've been wanting to make YouTube videos in general for a long time now, but this whole trade deadline stuff got me thinking, and I think it's time I finally put out a video. The really hot topic right now is Jerry Jeudy, Chase Claypool, make a move at all at receiver. Today, Kadarius Toney was just traded. So let's dive in. Now, when it comes to Claypool versus Jeudy in particular, I think you have to take a step back and look at what does Brian Daboll want in his system? And I was listening to Patricia Traina's stream with Tana and Bad Dog tonight, and she brought up a great point, which was Toney was a great fit for what the Giants want to do. The elite yak ability, elite separation ability. I think that's the first place that we have to look. Jerry Jeudy coming out of Alabama was a top half of the first round pick for one reason and one reason alone, and it's an elite ability to separate. You see that's really common. NFL GMs look at a bunch of different traits for receivers as a list they go down, and the number one thing on everyone's list, or at least for the majority, is the ability to separate. If you can't separate, can he go up and get the ball and be a contested catch guy? But when we're talking about separation, it's route running, it's stop start ability, speed, all those things factor in amongst other things like the nuances in how you run your route and how technically sound you are and coming in and out of breaks and wasted movement and those kinds of things. So Jerry Jeudy coming out, elite separator, elite route runner, right? Same thing with Amari Cooper from Bama, Calvin Ridley from Bama. Kadarius Toney wasn't an elite route runner, wasn't technically sound, but his stop-start ability is so ridiculous, it was just easy for him to separate. We saw, all those plays against Trayvon Diggs last year. So that's the first thing we have to look at. And Claypool is definitely not an elite route runner. He's okay, it's fine. I'm not dissing his route running ability at all, but it's nowhere near the level of a guy like Jerry Jeudy. When we look at getting a guy a number one receiver, right, and particularly Daniel Jones, people most commonly equate it to two different things, and it's Eli Manning got Burris, boom, Super Bowl, right? We look at Josh Allen, first year, not good at all. Second year, took off a little bit. Third year, Stephon Diggs, boom. And what makes it so easy for number one receiver, like particularly what we're looking at in Daboll's scheme, which is ability to separate. Stephon Diggs was giving Josh Allen all these open lanes to throw because he's separating such a high level, took all the pressure off him. He wasn't having to thread the needle as much. With Daniel Jones, we see him throwing the needle every single week. We need guys who can separate. Jerry Jeudy provides that. That's not Chase Claypool. And I love Claypool. I love him coming out. I did want him for the Giants, but for looking at what fits this Giants team in particular, I think it's Jerry Jeudy. People talk about, the drop numbers, and I think he had 10 drops his first year when he played in 16 games. And last year, he had a high ankle sprain against us, only played in 10 games, 5 starts, but one drop that whole season. I'm not counting this season. He's playing with the corpse of Russell Wilson. Like, I'm not going to blame him for what's going on there. There's a lot of things going on in the locker room, and I'm sure in his head it's getting to him. And there's a bunch of different factors that this year I'm really not going to blame him. We've seen improvement. We saw improvement in college too. Every year the drop numbers went down. And it's definitely not that he has bad hands. I think it's concentration drops. I really do. Things like looking to run before the ball is actually in his hands. It's something that can be coached. And I've seen a lot of people say in response to something like that, like, oh, why would we go through the whole headache of hoping, that he can fix these problems? And I've seen a bunch of different people say the same thing. Why would we have to hope he can fix it? Why hope he can fix it? Well, I would say that, we've seen what this coaching staff has done for a lot of the players on this team and taking their game to the next level. Look at guys like Dexter Lawrence and Andrew Thomas, they were good. They were never all pro good. That's how they're playing this year. Julian Love went from, replacement level starter to a plus starter at safety in the NFL this year, and a bunch of different areas too, not to mention Daniel Jones's play. And there's no reason to think that this coaching staff can't continue to do what it's done all year, which is bring out the best in the players that are on the roster. And I think they can do that with Jerry Jeudy. And Daboll knows Jeudy. When Jeudy was a freshman, Daboll was the offensive coordinator over at Bama. Having a target that could create these easy passing lanes for Daniel Jones and get open quickly is something I think that would really help him take his game to the next level. We've seen, over the past couple years, especially since Kenny Galladay's been here, Daniel Jones having the tendency to go deep less and less and less. Not to say that there haven't been route concepts that are worked into, the deep passing game with guys like Kenny Galladay. I just think Daniel Jones might not feel comfortable throwing it up to a guy that is blanketed, which Kenny Galladay is every single time he, streaks down the sideline with that big body. So I think that's why we see his connection with Darius Slayton. He's not that big body, but he has the speed to separate down there. And I think that might give Daniel Jones a sense of comfortability when he sees, the guy has a yard or two of separation, makes him feel more comfortable being able to fit the ball into a window. And that's what a guy like Jerry Jeudy brings to the table. I've also seen things like speed concerns with Jerry. Listen, to me, I don't know where that comes from. My only guess would be watching Broncos games last year after he's coming off of a high ankle sprain, and we know as Giants fans what that's like for some of our players to come back from that. When Saquon came back from that, his third year in the league, it took him a while before he really looked like himself. I mean, Saquon rushed for a single yard in a game against the Jets. I mean, he wasn't the same even though he was on the field. And, I think that deserves, that being said, we can give Jerry Jeudy that pass for last year. So my only guess is people watched a Broncos game from last season and Jerry didn't look that fast to them, on TV, not even on tape. And I would say I don't think that's very fair. His rookie year, he took a slant 92 yards to the house. Game one of this season, he caught a ball intermediate down the sideline and ran out of two tackles and took it to the house. I don't think speed's a concern there. He's a 4-4 guy, which is plenty fast in the NFL. In combination with his ability to run routes, that's lethal. It might as well be a 4-3 when you have that combination. Going on top of that, the injury concerns with Jerry Jeudy, he's had one major injury, which is the high ankle sprain, which takes time to come back from and really reach your full potential as far as physically, again, get back to where you were even. So I don't think that's very fair either. This injury-prone idea, really, it's not true. I don't know where that comes from. He had one injury last year. I guess we can go over to a guy like Claypool. Listen, Claypool is a talented receiver. Would I be happy if we were able to get him? Sure, I would. He's better than anyone we have on this team right now, and it's not even close. I will admit I am a Bama fan. There might be a bit of Bama bias there, but I'm doing my best to take all that bias out of this and just say I don't think that Chase Claypool is the kind of guy that Joe Shane and Brian Daboll are looking to put into this system. He is straight line fast, but he is not a very shifty receiver. He's not the best route runner. He's really, a nine route kind of guy. And listen, I'm not trying to come off like, I watch all this film and stuff. I mean, I dabble in it, and no pun intended, but and I do dive into draft film pretty heavily, but I'm nowhere near the level of guys like Nate and Diggy, so I'm really just going off of what I see personally. And if you guys disagree with me on any of this, feel free to comment down below. I'd love to hear you guys' thoughts, and that's the whole point of being able to have dialogue about anything, let alone sports, is being open to new ideas and different perspectives. And I'm more than happy to hear what you guys have to say on everything. So going back to before, I just don't think that Claypool is the type of guy the Giants are looking to bring in. Now, if those are the two main options and, there's a ridiculous difference in price between acquiring a guy like Jerry Jeudy and Chase Claypool, say, I don't know, Jerry Jeudy is going to cost you a second and a third, and Claypool will cost you a four and a five and a future seven or something like that, then sure, the price is two, the difference between the two receivers and what they are right now doesn't justify the difference in price, so I would understand. But if you're getting a similar deal between the two, for me, it's Jerry Jeudy. We, like I said before, the most translatable trait to succeeding in the NFL from college is the route running ability, and that high floor of him being able to get open. I can live with, a drop every other game. Not that that would be, but even if it is, the potential for it to get better and, be minimized as a problem, much like Tiki Barber's fumbles were minimized through coaching. I think the same can be done for Jerry Jeudy. I think if you have that where you have the drops, I can live with that. If you have a guy that's always open, and you're going to have a lot more of those plays where he's just open and just get him the ball and easy completions, I think that outweighs the bad, potential bad side, not even guaranteed, the potential downside of some drops. Odell had drop problems too, maybe not as bad as Jerry did in his rookie year, but. No, the whole catch percentage stat that's being thrown around, Jerry Jeudy's first to second year, it's night and day. It was like a 15-point difference in catch percentage. This year, I don't care. I'm not counting this year at all. Russell Wilson is not himself. Nathaniel Hackett's a poor play caller. I don't think you can hold this year against him. And this year brings down his average catch percentage, but it was almost 70%, I believe, in his second year, and just over 50% in his first year. So there was improvement there, and we have no reason to believe anything but the fact that Brian Daboll can get that out of him again. So all in all, would I be upset with either of these two guys? No, not at all. I would love to have Claypool. I'd love to have Jeudy. I just think that for me personally, I like Jerry more, liked him more as a prospect. Obviously, he was drafted way higher. But with the traits that are there and the things that, you just can't teach in that natural God-given ability to stop and start and his football IQ in regards to running routes and getting open is just, that's something that I can't pass up. Let me know what you think down in the comments. I'd love to hear everyone's opinions on this, different perspectives, and hey, who knows, maybe you could change my mind. I don't think so. Jerry Jeudy, I'm kind of a simp for Jerry Jeudy. He was my lock screen for about 2 years. Back when he was at Bama, I was that one guy that was saying I would not be upset with Jerry Jeudy at number four when we drafted Andrew Thomas. I was that guy. So, in all seriousness, no, I love Jerry Jeudy. It'd be a dream come true. I would buy his jersey in an instant. So, thanks again, guys, and hopefully see you soon. I've been living fast, 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 fast. Feeling really bad, 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 bad. Time really moves fast, 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 fast. But hurry up and get in your bag, 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 bag.